हेलो, आम आई ऑडिबल?
या यू ऑडिबल?
ओके
आई थिंक वी शुड वेट फॉर
सो
अनादर
हेलो
फाइव
एंड वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो आई वेलकम यू ऑल. I welcome you all to the webinar series of Anthropology and Pandemics, a journey that we have started on 15th of this May. And continuously, we organize this webinar on 15th and 16th. And after this gap, again, we organizing the second phase of this webinar that is on today. We are having the opportunity to listen Professor S.B. Roy. So I welcome you all, all the dignitaries, those are present in the class, and other participants, those are already logged in. And those are supposed to log in within 10 minutes. So I welcome you all to the webinar series. So hope we all done with our Sunday special lunch. So without making a delay, we should start. First of all, I just want to say, my name is Banita Behra, and I'm working for Anthropological Survey of India. So during this lockdown, we are having some idea that why people used to tell that why the anthropologists are not coming out with their suggestions and ideas, why we should not talking about this crisis and this pandemic situation. So at that time, we thought that we should create some platform to give the opportunity to listen all this expertise from different discipline of anthropology. So no matter where we are in the globe, we have all been impacted in some way as states, cities, municipalities, and we all been imposed with the certain restrictions in order to slow down the spread of coronavirus. So different expertise are coming out with strategies that can help the humankind to deal with the stress, grief, and anxiety that many people are feeling nowadays. So I would like to draw your attention that we are into collecting such lectures of the expertise from different branches of anthropology to illustrate how people are experiencing and responding to the COVID-19 crisis. So keeping in mind, so we have organized, we started the webinar series with the expertise of biomedical science. Then we came to the social aspect. In the second series, we invited different head of the anthropological department of Pondicherry and Mysore, Calcutta University, and Anthropological Survey of India. So they came out with a lot of suggestions and research work on this COVID-19. So in the coming series, today's series, we are trying to portray the biosocial trauma that we are going through due to this COVID-19 crisis. So I am having this opportunity to introduce Professor S.B. Roy, who is the chairman of IBRAD, Indian Institute of Biosocial Research and Development. Professor, he was the former professor of IIT Kharagpur, former visiting professor at different university like Manchester, UK, Finland. And he was one of the expert ex-member of GMU Indonesia and SWFC China. And now he is the expert member in the BMC, NBA, GIM, Government of India. So one interesting thing I would like to underline about Professor Roy, after this lockdown situation, whenever we are going to log in any kind of webinar series or any Facebook live lectures, at this age, I would like to tell the all gathering that Professor Roy at this age also continuously back to back, he's present in all the webinar series. First of all, you will finish one webinar series. Then after half an hour, I will see he's present in another series, in another live Facebook like live lecture. So like this, I want to tell you that at this age also, sir is so dynamic and see he is so much interested to speak and learn about this situation. I must congratulate sir. Sir, we should learn from you. So today we are having the opportunity to listen Professor S.B. Roy. So without making a delay, I would like to request sir to come and give his talk on his topic. And another thing I would like to announce that we are having 10 expertise in our classroom today, the dignitaries from different fields. We will grab the opportunity to listen them also at the discussion session. So I would like to request, sir, Professor S.B. Roy, sir, please come and give
Welcome, friends. Once again, I express my gratitude, compliment to the organizer, Origin Life. Friends, it is very, very important for us to know about our life, environment, and also how we are interacting with the environment. A few days back, I had shared on Facebook that this coronavirus, I consider coronavirus as a biosocial trauma. It's a trauma. The sudden attack, which has kept people unprepared, and it is not attack to individual or attack to a group of people, rather it is attack on the human group at all together. And such attack of corona is on the biological entity of human body.
Sir, I just want to interrupt.
So, it's immediate effect on the biological body. Yes, please.
Sir, is any microphone or any audio thing is open? Because we are having an audio.
Okay.
Let me have an audio.
Okay.
Otherwise, your voice is not very clear. I think some speaker is on.
A loudspeaker.
Is it all right now?
Yes, sir. Perfect, sir.
Yes, sir. Perfect, sir.
Okay. So this attack of corona is on the biological entity of human body. So the trauma is on the human body, the biological aspect. But attack on the biological has caused several changes in the human structure and functioning because of the social distancing, because of the lockdown, severe implication on the economic activities, on the structural activities. We do not remember in our history there has been any person which has been such severe attack. That's why we call it a trauma. And this trauma has caused uncertainty, confusion, and it also has a lot of problem on the structural changes of the society overall. So this is the implication on the biological, causing health and the social structure and economy. Now, in view of that, if human society has to defend against corona, till today, for defense, we do not have any preventive measure of immunization. But till today, we don't have a very effective treatment for coronavirus. The only thing which we have now to protect ourselves. How do you protect ourselves? Protecting ourselves through making social distance, washing our hand frequently as been advised at 22nd, cover your face with a mask when you cough or go, have nutritious food, and very, very important, improve your immunity. So we have to take care of improvement of our immunity, improvement of our health, and also improvement of our social structure, making social distance. So this kind of change has started. Now here, the question will be, what will be the role of anthropologist, role of social scientist to mitigate the negative or the consequences of the corona on the human body and human society, both. What could be role of anthropology? So I'll be talking to you now about the role of anthropology, where it has come for the holistic study. See, anthropology is a discipline which study biological issues and social issues together as a bio-social issues. That is why it is holistic study. And maybe the medical discipline, they will be studying the anatomy, physiology, or medicine. Maybe the economists, they will be working on the economic challenges. Maybe the sociologists will be working on the social structure and function. But the interwoven, interdependent relationship with the human body, biological issue of human, which is interwoven with the society, social structure, social function, will be understood by the anthropologist. That is why anthropologist study is known as holistic study, and I call it biosocial trauma. Incidentally, I will tell you, the organization which we have founded with a group of anthropologists, I remember, I acknowledge, I pay respect of those who supported, from Delhi University, Professor I.P. Singh, Professor Rotho from Sambalpur, Dr. K.C. Malhotra from Indian Statistical Institute, and there are many who are with us, like Vishwanath Sarkar, or one of our colleagues, she has left the world, Mitali, she has been founder secretary, Dr. Jaya Chaudhary, Dr. Sheila Kudukodar, all are anthropologists who visualize that in order to have a development of society as a whole, we cannot conduct study or intervention just by seeing the social issues or the biological issues. I keep on emphasizing this, that if you study anthropology, that means you have to have both biological issues and social issues. That's why the biosocial. So the first part of my lecture, I wanted to make it clear that the role of anthropologist is understanding the biosocial issues which are interwoven, the biosocial issues which are interdependent, and one cannot find answer in isolation. This is first part. Now coming to the topic of what anthropologists will be doing. I have been talking to my friends that here in anthropology, what we see that step by step, we go and study in the field. I remember, I'll show my slides. See, can you see one of my slides? Strategies for mitigation of biosocial trauma.
Well, sir, the slide has not yet started. It will take some time, I think. It's coming up, sir. Just a moment.
You can't see my slide.
It will come up, sir. It takes time to open.
Oh, it's taking time to open.
Yes, sir.
All right. By the time it is opening, I can talk.
Yes, sir.
See?
Yes, sir.
Here it is an anthropology journey. And in the biosocial trauma, how anthropologists will study for mitigation of biosocial trauma due to Cornell. I have used the word strategies. In the whole of my discourse, I will be talking about anthropological theory, some of them, anthropological methods, and how anthropological methods and theory will be enriched by incorporating some other knowledge. So I call it Anthropology Plus. Let me begin with this. All of you as an anthropologist know Malinowski has been one of the very famous anthropologists who has started on the study, and in the ethnography study, he mentioned that human society attempts to meet the physiological need first, biological need first. That means how he is going to get his food. He will move. He'll try to procure food. He'll try to procure some place for the shelter. We look for water. Where is he going to get water? He's going for his physiological need for reproduction. So all such activities, which is the very fundamental activities of human society, is meeting the physiological need. So what Malinowski has mentioned about the physiological need, it stands today also. So I will be talking of those anthropological theories which are relevant today and how we will enrich the anthropological theory with the other knowledge to make it more effective. That is the purpose of my deliberation, and I call it Anthropology Plus. So the anthropology is meeting physiological need, what Malinowski has mentioned. And then he mentioned, in order to meet the biological need, he has some activities and developed some structure and made the institution. That means the human society makes some rule. Who will do what? How to get food? And he mentioned that when you go for field work, you have to talk to them and you have to observe what they are doing. He mentioned very important work, that it is not important just to talk to them, ask questions, fill up your schedule, and write report. This is very important thing, that often when you ask the question, they will say what is ideal, what it should be done. I remember Professor Srivastava, Director Anthropological Survey of India, few days back during his discourse, he mentioned about the Malinowski, and he also mentioned that people may say the ideal norm, but actually they may not be doing it. So Malinowski has said, people say what I do, but actually they don't do. So what you have to say, you have to see what they are saying and what they are doing. That is why there is a need for participatory observation. Now, here is this method, although Professor Srivastava mentioned this word participatory observation was not coined by Malinowski, it was from her. But Malinowski emphasized on the ethnography, the study and observation. And also he made for the interpretation. So this is the first part I have to mention, that human society, for meeting the physical need, they will have some activities, and also they'll form some structures, some rule. It is called as the institution. He mentioned about the structuralism.
So later, your PPT is not yet visible, sir.
Sorry?
Your PPT is not yet visible.
Your PPT is not yet visible.
It's not visible?
No.
No.
So sir, don't share the content. You can use option share file.
Use option share file.
Yes, it's okay now, sir.
Yes, it's okay now, sir.
Now it's okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you can see my slide?
Yes, sir. It's visible now.
Yes, sir. It's visible now.
Okay, and you can hear me also.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
So, in this journey, as I mentioned, maybe I'll keep on repeating this thing, that I will be sharing the anthropological theory and concept, and then I will making Anthropology Plus. That means how this theory will be enriched to make the knowledge applicable. That is my intention. After the Malinowski, he also mentioned very important thing, that people watch and intubate. Now, there's another term which is often used in anthropology about the perception of the human development. See, we all anthropologists want to work for the human development. If I ask you, what is human development? And my dear friend, many anthropologists are listening, even other discipline people are listening. If I ask you, tell me one or two sentences, what do you mean by human development? And I'm sure out of 10 anthropologists, there will be hardly 3 or 4 common answers. That means we anthropologists do not have a standard method, definition, and concept of human development. I'll show you this slide. Look at this. Can you see? See, this is a very common story. In our childhood also we studied how few blinds were asked to describe an elephant. And each blind described elephant in their own way. Imagine if anthropologists define human development the way blinds are describing in parts, will it be human development? That is why we have to know, when we see human development, what do we mean by human development? And all anthropologists, all sociologists, all economists must understand the meaning of human development, and a picture of human development should emerge. If I tell you, what is a leaf? When I ask you the picture of leaf, all those who are listening, they will have a picture of something flat and of green color, maybe different shape. But no one will say that leaf is like a log or leaf is like a glass. That means when you utter a word, the picture should emerge, everyone's back of mind the same. Then only we understand universally. So we have to understand the picture of human development. And unless we understand the picture of human development, each anthropologist will be talking in their own way and will be having argument and debate. So there has been some standard definition of human development, standard method of human development in the context of corona also. If I say a particular person is suffering from corona, what is the implication of the human development? How do we know about it? So, again, I remember Professor Srivastava, he referred that when you are talking with the community, when you are going for the development, you must know human development index. I remember what Professor Srivastava mentioned. And here, when you talk of the human development, each one has got their own worldview. Again, we are using this term in anthropology, worldview. That means how one person view other. This is a very important, a fundamental cognitive orientation. And this is the knowledge of this individual and society. So when you are working, even in Adivasi, tribal belt, and if you go and ask, what kind of disease is corona? And if they describe corona in their own way, in different way, then it will be very difficult to create awareness, and it will be very difficult to design a standard pattern of behavior. I repeat, if the worldview of corona is conceived differently by different tribal or by different community, we cannot develop a standard method of preventive measure. We cannot develop a standard method even for curative. So as an anthropologist, we must understand how community perceive, what is the worldview about the corona. And if we understand, then we, if there are different method, different notion of different worldview of the corona, then we have to have a common design. So my question is that when there is a coronavirus pandemic, what is the worldview which globally understand, and when we go to the village, do they have the same or different? If they are having different, then we have to think how to standardize the method of prevention, curative, and taking care. So that is why I have used this portion of understanding the worldview. I'll discuss again whether we can understand the worldview. And the second question to anthropologists, can we change worldview? Can we change orientation? Can we change the notion? This is become challenge. I will come again. Coming back, what I have mentioned already, that what people have got worldview. What people have, this worldview is also a kind of belief system. See, interestingly, I will be mentioning here the worldview, the belief system,